into the second day of Group 2 in Championship League Snooker 2017. By the end of today, we'll know the second name for the winners' group in early March. Dave Gilbert already through as the winner of Group 1. Top four players in this section will go into the Group 2 semi-finals tonight, and the eventual winner will then claim a place in that winners' group. Cracking start to the day from Mark Davis, who had a pretty good day yesterday, won two of his three matches. Davis, the lowest ranked player in this group at number 31 in the world. Neil Robertson is the highest at number 7. Day was the star performer of day one in this group. He won all three of his matches, so he's the only undefeated player. And then four players on two wins each. Mark Davis and Neil Robertson, who are playing each other here, both with two wins from three. And then Anthony McGill and Matt Selt, both two wins from four. Mark Williams, down in sixth place, only one win from three matches. And Michael White, bottom of the table, he lost all four yesterday. I think it's worth mentioning, no practice tables here, so the players come in at the start of the day cold, so it's always very impressive when they put together any sort of break straight off the bat in the first match of the day. He didn't really look comfortable on that shot, Davis. It was a tricky one. But can Robertson get through to this one that's been left over the middle? The other reds might be in the way. Plenty of room to get through. And he's finished nowhere with the cue ball. Bad evening all round for Neil Robertson last night. He had won his first two matches of the day, and then saw his winning run ended by a 3-1 defeat against Matt Selt. And then he went and watched his football team, Chelsea, lose 2-0 to Tottenham, bringing an end to their own winning run. They had won 13 Premier League. Split there, and when he got into situations like this in that defeat by Celt, he was fairly comfortable, but other than that he was making a lot of mistakes, and it was a really poor performance overall. Breaks of 76 and 55 in the Celt match last night. Just at other times when he wasn't in among the balls, just seemed to be struggling for focus and just couldn't get on top of things. good frame-winning chance, but a bit of work to do to develop the other reds. Suggest that one of these reds goes to the middle. And that frees up the other two reds now. So should win the frame here. So that was frame ball. Every chance now of a century. That the six colours would give him exactly 100. And he's a player who actually pays a lot of attention to his century stats, not far short of 500 for his career now. So it was Davis who got in first in this frame. Knocked in a really good long red, made 31 but missed a red to the middle. And in the end, with that break of exactly 100, it's Neil Robertson who's won the opening frame against Mark Davis. Good start to the day all round for the two former world champions in this group. Neil Robertson 1-0 up here, and Mark Williams leading 1-0 on the other table against his fellow Welshman Ryan Day, who is the only player to go through the first day of the group undefeated. Williams in need of a result there. He's only had one win out of three so far. Part of Neil Robertson's objective in Championship League this week, and indeed next week if he's involved again, is to get some matches under his belt, I think, ahead of the Masters. Tends to focus very much these days on the standout events like the World, the UK and the Masters, which he is a former winner of. Struggling a bit for results before Christmas and could do with getting some match play under his belt before he goes to Alexandra Palace. And he actually starts in the last match of the first round on the Wednesday night. Against Ali Carter. Tuesday night he plays. Well, looks to be in good, sharp form early on today. Played pretty well for most of yesterday, barring that surprisingly low-key performance against Celt. He had already enjoyed 3-1 wins over Mark Williams and Michael White. Seems to feel that was a bad contact. Intended to be much further away from the cushion than this. Well off target with the attempted recovery. So a chance for Davis. Angle here to develop some of those reds below the pink if he chooses. They've split quite nicely. Dave has played pretty well yesterday and might well have won all three of his matches. He was 2-0 up against Ryan Day. Playing really well. Day came back to 2-2. Davis looked like he was going to take it in the decider and then had an unfortunate kick at a key moment. And Day ended up getting back in to win. Davis won his other two matches yesterday against Matt Selt and Anthony McGill. He's looking to reach his fifth group semi-final in a row. Got to the semi-finals of groups 5, 6 and 7 last year. Beaten in the semis each time by Kyron Wilson, Ali Carter and Matt Selt.
37.
And then he lost to Dave Gilbert in the semi-finals of Group 1 this year.
38.
Blue will take his lead to 32. Just need one more red and any colour except yellow. Just the one snooker needed, though. So he could do with taking this last red. I don't think we'll be seeing Robertson back to the table now.
Not quite enough there to make the century.
Break of 81 from Mark Davis, a good response to Neil Robertson's opening frame century, and they're level at 1-1.
Similar story on the other table. One all there. Ryan Day has taken the second frame against Mark Williams to level that one. Been much wrong with his long game. Very, very best long potters we've seen in the game over the years. Sometimes his short game lets him down. Just when it looked as though Roberts might be off and running. This is a relatively routine red. He broke down just 26 in the previous frame. He was punished to the full. Didn't get another shot. That's worked out pretty well.
16.
You saw in the previous frame, he's into his rhythm already. This one a bit awkward for himself.
22. Touching ball. Thank you.
not on anything ideally, but he does still have this red to the right corner and also the option of taking a red to the right centre. Just making things a little difficult for himself over the last few shots. Long way out with that one in the end. Once more, let's let Robertson back in. Mentioned Robertson wasn't having the best of runs just before Christmas. He actually started this season pretty well. He won the Riga Masters, which is a ranking event now. Beat Michael Holt in the final of that. Got to the semi-finals of the World Open in China.
14.
He was also a semi-finalist at the European Masters in Bucharest. Other than that, it's not been great. A low point probably came when he went to York in November to defend the UK title and lost in his first match to the veteran Peter Lines. Here in Coventry, just before that, he'd come to defend his Champion of Champions title that he'd also won during that great golden spell he enjoyed towards the end of 2015. But in that tournament, he also lost his first match in defence of the title, going down to Stuart Bingham. Bit better at the Scottish Open, the last tournament before Christmas, got to the last 16, ended up losing out in a deciding frame to the eventual winner of that tournament, Marco Fu. Second half of last season was a bit of a disappointment to him in the end. Lost the Welsh Open final to Ronnie O'Sullivan. It all culminated in a first round defeat against Michael Holt at the World Championship. So as we turn into 2017, he'll be very keen to get back to the sort of form and consistency that he was showing a couple of years ago. Some more wins and good results under his belt here. A good springboard with which to start the new year.
Thank you.
as he brings up the half century. He's 32 in front. So needs red, colour red. Not worked out ideally at all. I think Davis is going to be coming back 60. To the table. Was an ambitious attempt. There's always that temptation to just push the boat out a little bit. You're just one ball away from clinching the frame. He's not done any damage anyway. Robertson straight back in, almost certainly now to clinch the frame here. Wow. We've seen a good standard. 100 from Robertson in the first, 81 from Davis in the second, 61 here. Goes back into the lead over Mark Davis, 2 frames to 1. Looking good for Ryan Day over on the other table. He's come from 1-0 down to now lead Mark Williams by 2 frames to 1, and needs just one more to make it 4 wins from 4 matches. It's only ever happened 7 times that a player has gone through the round robin stage of a group, winning 6 out of 6. Saw 2 players do it last year, Ronnie O'Sullivan and Mark Selby. Day can get one more frame in that match, and then beat Michael White, who's lost all of his matches so far. And that would send him into his last match against Neil Robertson with a chance to join that fairly exclusive club. Might take the opportunity here to just develop a few more reds. And playing that shot, that was always the danger. He wouldn't get through the reds the way he needed to. Well, they've already looked at each other.
Yeah.
Suggested the re-rack. And that's what's happening. And I think that's probably the right decision. Davis did have a bit of a lead, but only 17 points, so I think he was happy enough. And so we'll re-rack and start again. While Brendan Moore is setting them up, I can tell you that it's finished on the other table. Ryan Day, having lost the first frame, has won three in a row to beat Mark Williams by 3-1. Looks to be in excellent form. Total frames count for his four matches is 12-4. So he's set for a place in the semi-finals of the group. Just two wins away from making it only the eighth time in the Championship League's 10-year history that a player has won all six matches in the round-robin section. Straight back on that table now to play Michael White. White struggled yesterday, lost all four of his matches. The last thing he needs now is to be facing an opponent in such good form. Robertson in first, and it's a pretty good chance.
Three.
Quite a few reds out in the open.
Four.
Obviously, the important thing is to win the match, but if you can, you want to get it done as quickly as possible. Second day of a group. It'll be a long day. Robertson's got
nine
matches to play in total in the round robin section, and then obviously hope to be involved in the semi-finals and hopefully even the final tonight. So to conserve as much energy as possible. To a bit of bother here. You can still fancy him to get this one though. Never guaranteed. So having been 17-0 up in this frame just a few minutes ago, following the re-rack, Davis now comes to the table 17-0 down. little recovery shot there. He's very good at sustaining breaks in difficult situations. If things go slightly wrong, he's out of ideal position during a break. He's very good at putting it out of his mind and getting on and playing a good recovery. Seems to be a bit of a struggle for him at the moment. Nothing quite going to plan. Again, pulls out a good recovery shot. He's never been the most fluent, natural of scorers. Certainly can be on his day, but most of the time to scrap it out a bit more, but he's very good at keeping breaks going. Things aren't going entirely to plan. Plays really good recovery shots. It's actually a really big strength of his. Well, it would be some effort if he was to win the frame. One go here. Plain sailing, by any means. will be end of break now.
45.
All in all, that was a pretty good effort. Don't think Davis will feel he's passed up a great chance to win the frame there. What he has done is put himself in a very strong position in it as he looks to take us to a decider. Misjudge that. This could be a chance for Robertson to nick this frame. Black is on the cushion, pink is a bit awkward. So, some work to be done to sort this out, but if he can, he'll close out the match. Does the red below the black go? I think we'll see when Brendan Moore gets out of the way. Oh, it certainly does. It's a real chance now. I decided to take the one to the middle instead. I think he's let Davis back in here. So it looks like two all now. This final red. Davis has already played four deciding frame finishes this week between groups one and two. He's won two of them, lost two of them. Going to play another one now. Mark Davis levels the match against Neil Robertson. Two frames all. An important frame for Neil Robertson, this. As I was saying, I think he would have come here looking to get some wins and some confidence going after a disappointing finish to 2016. If he doesn't win this frame, he's going to find himself only 2 wins from 4. Very nicely judged. Robertson, very quickly in this frame, is right where he wants to be, in among the balls. Whoever wins this final frame will be in second place in the group. Once this match is over, everyone will have played 4. Ryan Day will be top with 4 wins. Whoever wins this will be in second place with 3 wins.
Wow.
He's taking a long, lingering look at that ball cushion. I think he feels he's got a very irregular bounce. push and a tap by Munit for his problems. I think went for a red there that simply wasn't on. Davis still very much in the match. Might seem a bit risky taking on the double, but the way he's played it, couldn't really leave anything. So it was worth a go. Two ball tight on the ball cushion has made this a very difficult shot now for Davis. That mistake could be his last. One. ask for a much better chance than this to finish off the match. Into the table already with a useful 23-point lead. Very focused, very zoned in now. Just to get this match won. And have a bit of a break then. Before playing two in a row this afternoon against Anthony McGill and Ryan Day. Davis will also have a bit of a break before he plays Mark Williams and Michael White in succession. Black will take the lead to 62. One more red, a high value colour. This does look like the end now. It's not been a bad all performance from Neil Robertson. Had his problems at times, but breaks of 100, 61. This contribution here. May not be quite over yet, because by taking the green, he's going to leave himself still needing one more red. Just about pop the higher of the two reds just above the pink. Obviously wasn't on that red that I referred to, because otherwise he would have played it.
Yeah, Robertson, of course.
So Robertson still needs one more. 67 left on the table. I'm a little surprised that he took the green when he could have played a slightly trickier blue, which I think he still would have fancied getting, then that would have left Davis needing a snooker. Davis needs to take blacks with all five remaining reds. He does. He takes the colours. He'll win by a point. Suddenly, Davis needs two snookers. No doubt about it now, Neil Robertson has come through this match. Played fairly well at times. Overall, it's not been a vintage performance. So everyone has now played four matches. Ryan Day top with four wins. Neil Robertson in second place on three. Mark Davis then in third place with two wins. He's ahead on the frames count back of the other two players who have had two wins, Anthony McGill and Matthew Selt. Mark Williams in sixth place, just one win for him from four matches. And Michael White bottom of the table after four defeats out of four. Match up on this table will be a fairly key match. Selt and McGill both on two wins. So as they face each other, it will have a big impact on their respective prospects of going through to the group semi-finals.
32.
Mark Davis has battled well in this match. Neil Robertson a good contest. Robertson started this match with a century, break of exactly 100 in the first frame.
46.
He's added breaks of 61. 43. And with that clearance of 59, completes victory over Mark Davis by three frames to two. They'll both be back in action this afternoon. Next up on this table, it's Matthew Selt of England against Scotland's Anthony McGill.